Hey, I'm Cameron McKenzie at CameronMCNZ on Twitter. I want to talk to you about form validation. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a form that looks like this, has some input fields, and when somebody doesn't provide the right data, I'm going to give them some punitive red ink and tell them to fill it out properly. Now, one thing I do want to tell you is this tutorial is actually this tutorial here over on struts.apache.org, except I'm using annotations instead of XML. So if you actually want to see this particular tutorial written up and all in text and explained that way as well to complement this, head over to struts.apache.org and look for that form validation tutorial. Here's the little application that we've built so far. Just you register some information for the user, and if you type stuff in and you click submit, well, it first comes from this register page. It calls on the register action. If the register action's execute method is successful, it goes to the thank you JSP, and it all uses this person bean, which is really just this person class here, which is properties like first name, last name, and email. The problem with our application, if we take a look at it though, is there's no validation. So if I run this on the server and I just type junk in, it works. Now we can fix that problem quite easily. All we have to do is make sure that when our register action runs, we actually validate the input. And that means putting in a simple little validate method right after our execute method. Well, it can go anywhere, but it does have to be a method named validate. And the way this validate method works is we just evaluate various fields. I'm going to keep the validation simple here, so I'll just check to make sure that somebody's typed the first name in the person bean. The person bean, that's the person bean right there. It's just an instance of the person class. So we'll make sure the length of the person bean isn't zero. And if it's not, what we're going to do is we're going to add a field error, and we're going to say, hey, that person bean's first name is required. Now, the reason why we use the person bean that first name syntax here is because in the register.jsp, you'll notice that we call it first person bean.first name in the struts text field. So that kind of maps this field here to this error message here. And we're going to go and we're going to validate the email. I'm not going to use a regex for the email. I could use a regex to make sure there's an at and there's text before the at and a dot and then a ending after that. I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to make sure that it's there, length is zero. We see person bean email, a little message. And then maybe we'll just make sure that you have to be 18 to use this application. So we now add on person bean.age and say age is required. Now, one thing I do want to point out, notice this register action, it extends action support. That's a special class that comes from the Open Symfony XWorks package here, which is part of Struts, but it does provide me, you know, certain benefits. Like I don't have to type success in quotes, I can just say success there. I just want to point that out, so make sure you're extending that class, getting that support. Now, one of the things that happens with the validate method is if any of these field errors get populated, if any field errors are created, we assume that there's new input, extra input that's required from the user. So if any of these field errors get populated, get added, the return by default is not success, but it's actually a term called input. We don't have to write that here, but if there's any field errors, then what we need to do is we need to get more input from the user. A return code of input is automatically generated, which means I have to go up here and I have to add a new result. So I've got the result for success. What do? We go to thank you. But what happens if the result is input? Well, I have to add a new result here. I say name equals input, and we want to send them back to the register page. Want to send them back to the register JSP. Now you notice there's an error there. That's because you can't have two results, result annotations sitting by themselves unless they are inside a results plural annotation. And so I add results plural up there. Of course, I then need a comma right there, and then I need to close the whole thing with a chicken-lit bracket and then a round bracket. And hey, you know, maybe be polite and format that a little bit just to make it look like that. But now we say, look, if the result is success, we'll go to thank you. But if the result is we need more input, which is what happens, if this validate method fails, or at least, you know, we get some field errors generated, well, if we need more input, we send them back to the register page. Now, the other thing that's cool is if they don't put anything in for the first name, that person being first name field, you see that person name, first name field where we ask for their first name, that's going to get tagged with a message that says, hey, the first name is required. Now, I don't have to do anything to this register JSP, but if I actually want the results, the error messages to come out in a nice, well, I don't know if it's nice, but in a punitive red color, what I should do is I should add the struts head tag. It's going to add some formatting. So I'm going to go over to my register JSP. I'm going to add the head tag. I didn't do that before, just kind of lazy. Then I'm going to put this S colon head in there. And when I do this, it'll actually kind of make the error messages look more punitive, make them big and red, and kind of make things look cool. Anyways, okay, now I'm done this. I'm going to kick this off again. Restart the server. I don't know if it's necessary right now. I didn't hit any configuration. Well, I guess I did the results, but I always like to do that regardless. It's Tomcat, so it happens practically instantaneously. And now I'll run this on the server once again. And let's say I don't put a first name in, I don't put a last name in, I don't put an email in, and I make the age 12 and click submit. Well, look what happens. Now, I didn't validate last name, I don't believe, right? So if you look here, you can see there's no validation for last name. So that's why nothing happens to the last name. But notice all of these labels here, they come back a punitive red. We even say, hey, the first name is required, the email is required, and the age is required as well. And so now we've automatically done all of this validation simply by adding this validate method to our code. And there you go. That's how easy it is to just add some validation to your struts forms. Now, if you enjoyed that tutorial, head over to theserverside.com. I'm the editor-in-chief over there. I've got lots of great tutorials on struts, Spring, Hibernate, you name it, any enterprise software development topic. It is on the table for theserverside.com. If you're interested in my personal antics, follow me on Twitter at CameronMCNZ and subscribe on YouTube.